Hey everybody, welcome back to the Historian's Wardrobe YouTube channel. I'm Mariana, and I'm so glad that you're here with me today. Today is the second part of a three-part series that I'm doing on ladies' 1860s fashion. And in the 1860s, ladies had many different rules and regulations and things about their fashion, some of which I talked about last week in my video. And this week, I'm talking about headwear, and I'm making my own bonnet. This could be a complete and wonderful success, or a complete and utter disaster. So I'm making this bonnet out of using buckram and millinery wire, which I've never used before of either material. And if it's a failure, I learned something. So in the 1860s, ladies would wear different things in their hair. Their hair was always up and off their shoulders, out of their face. Sometimes ladies would wear what is called a snood, and it's kind of like a fancy lunch lady hairnet, but they would use it to hold their hair up, and that way their hair wasn't falling out. These snoods would get pretty fancy. They're kind of like crocheted. Sometimes they would put little ribbons at the top where it met the hair, and they'd ruche the ribbons and make it look really fancy. Some ladies would wear caps. Some ladies would wear straw hats. Some ladies would wear bonnets. And most often ladies would wear bonnets. Almost every woman probably did have a bonnet, because if you were going out, it was probably best for your hair to be covered. But I hope this works out, because I drafted my own pattern and it may not be great, but we'll see. Finished my bonnet form. Voila! It turned out a little taller than I was anticipating. I didn't expect it to be this tall. I don't know, it's my own fault for making my own pattern. Anyway, so I got it all hand sewn together. I did learn one lesson in this though, because I started by sewing this part to the back circle. And I should have sewn this first before I attached these, but whatever, lesson learned. Okay, so here's the bonnet on my creepy little head here that I got at Sally's. It's clearly way smaller than my own head, but it should work fine. The next step, I'm gonna put some plastic down below this, and then we're going to spray it with starch spray just to make it extra stiff. Even though the buckram itself is really stiff, it's a stiff cotton, I want to add a little extra stiffness and extra support. So you can see wrinkles in it from all my hand sewing. It's a mess. Okay, so this is what I'm using to spray onto the bonnet. We'll be right back.
You had a plenty money, 1922. You let other women make a fool of you. Why don't you do right like some of the men do? Get out of here and get me some money.
Or whatever you call it is too big. If this was a true ladies 1860s bonnet, I wouldn't look so much like Bo Peep and have this potato chip coming out of my head, and it wouldn't be so tall back here. But you know what? I learned. So clearly this was a disaster. And that's the way the cookie crumbles. Even though it was an utter failure, I didn't expect to do everything perfect, and I certainly didn't. I completely failed on this project, but you know what? I'm still gonna show you how I failed. Because failure is what makes us better. It's gonna be a minute before I ever attempt another bonnet. I'll tell you that right now. I'm bitter. I just want to thank you all again so much for all the support that I've received and all the nice comments and messages. So thank you guys so much. If you're new to this channel or you've been here for the first couple of weeks, I'm so thankful that you're here. Please subscribe, follow, and stay tuned for more. Thanks again. Bye.